Hi everyone, I'm Alex Janoski, Director of Client Services here at Rock Island Auction Company. And what we got here today is we're starting off our top 50 for the upcoming premier auction in May, which is May 14th through the 16th, with preview on Thursday the 13th. Kicking off our list with number 50, what we have here is a pair of modern U.S. Marine Corps rifles. The first here is a Remington M40A3. This rifle is built using one of only 10 commercially available Remington 700 actions that were originally produced for manufacture of the M40A3 sniper rifles. An included letter from D.D. Ross Company states that these 10 actions were purchased from Remington in 2001 and fall within the correct serial number range and were made to Marine Corps standards. The letter concludes that these 10 actions represent the only legitimate USMC actions that are commercially available and cannot be replicated. The rifle is fitted with a USMC scope as seen here. This is the closest thing to a US Marine Corps issued M40A3 available on the commercial market. Next is a US Gulf War Barrett M82A1 50 BMG sniper rifle. These don't need much of an introduction here. The monstrous Barrett 50 cal is about as iconic as they come, and known for its uses as an anti-material rifle and sniping at ranges well beyond conventional rifles. So this M82A1 actually is listed in Norman Chandler's book, Death from Afar, as one of the first 100 rifles delivered to the U.S. Marine Corps for use in Operation Desert Shield. Reportedly, the first 100 Barretts were sent straight from the factory to Saudi Arabia to be distributed to combat elements. Afterwards, only about 35 of these rifles were reported to make it into civilian hands, as the rest were given to foreign allies or disposed of. So with that being said, these two Marine Corps rifles kick off our list at number 50. At number 49 here, we have an outstanding World War II U.S.-inspected Colt Super 38 pistol with the box. The included factory letter states that this pistol was part of a 24-piece shipment to Resident Inspector of Ordnance at Remington, which places it as part of a very limited run of late World War II Super 38s ordered by the government. 400 were ordered in total, with 24 delivered to Remington and the remaining to the Military Administrative and Supply Division at the Fowler Building in Rosslyn, Virginia. According to Douglas Sheldon's book, Colt Super 38, it is speculated that there was a massive typo in the ammunition order when the government ordered the Super 38s. A typo to the tune of 32 million rounds of ammo. So I don't know who was there when that came through, but I bet they got a little excited that they had 32 million rounds of ammo to test. Once the confusion was all kind of sorted out, 20 of the pistols were routed through Springfield to the Pentagon, with their final destination being unknown. It has been speculated that the original destinations of these pistols was the OSS, as the Fowler Building, as mentioned previously, acted as one of their warehouses. Out of the 400 U.S. 38 Supers, only 13 had been identified by Sheldon at the time of the publishing of his book, suggesting that this pistol is extremely, extremely fresh to the market, and that finding another one, let alone better than this one, is highly unlikely, which is why this Remington-shipped Colt U.S. 38 Super is number 49 on our list. Here we go on number 48, which is a grouping of beautiful pocket pistols to be offered in our May premiere auction. What these pistols lack in size, they certainly make up for in elegance and eye appeal. First to my left here is an LD Nimshki Master Engraved Gold Plated American Standard Tool Company pocket revolver with the pearl grips. This has to be amongst one of the finest decorated 19th century pocket revolvers known to exist. The gun features near full coverage engraving and is fitted with these gorgeous pearl grips. When you get the catalogs, take a look. I mean, when you're looking at this thing, there's not much on there that isn't engraved. It's about all over there. I mean, maybe on the muzzle on the front of the cylinder, but that's about it. And then moving to my right here, the next is this pair of Colt Thor third model Derringers. These guns aren't engraved, but they are just out of this world in condition. If this isn't mint, then I don't really know what is. And then these pistols actually come with a rare factory picture box, which has the wood dowels in there, which those would have came in. So, I mean, I haven't seen many of these ever come through, if any at all. And then third, and definitely not least, is this case pair of factory engraved brown Southerner Derringers, which are gold and silver plated. Despite their name, Southerner, they were manufactured well in the north in Newburyport, Massachusetts. These Derringers are pretty hard to find with any condition, let alone special finish options like these, such as the engraving, the gold wash barrels, the silver plating, and the pearl grips. Along with that, there are case pair, which is pretty rare in themselves. So here they are, some mighty fine pocket pistols, which are number 48 on our list. Let's get started on number 47 on our top 50 list. What we have here are two belt-fed machine guns. And so this is only two of the over 120 Class 3s that we have coming up for sale in this auction. And I'm sure you'll hear more as we get going down the top 50. For every item, every number on our top 50 list, there's going to be 10 more, a dozen more items that are more than deserving to be on this list as well. So you have to be sure to go check out the catalog. But let's get started. Here we go. On my left, we have an HK21 squad automatic weapon. It was originally manufactured in Germany as an HK91 and was subsequently upgraded by Vollmer Manufacturing to the HK21 pattern. And then it was upgraded by Fleming Firearms with the fully automatic trigger pack. This HK21 remains in exceptional condition and looks like it's hardly been shot. Moving to my right here, the second is the SACO Defense M60 General Purpose Machine Gun. The M60 is quite a weapon. So it was developed in the late 50s to be a single weapon that replaced as many different 30 caliber machine guns in the Army inventory as possible. The M60 was deployed as the chief infantry machine gun for Vietnam, along with a variety of vehicle mountings, and is still a frontline automatic weapon. So the first of our Class 3s, but definitely not the last, as you'll see, and only a small, tiny selection of over 120 coming up in the May premiere auction are these two Class 3s at number 47 on our list. Here we are with the first sporting gun on our list, number 46. It is a Wilkins & Company 700 Nitro Express double rifle, engraved and gold inlaid with an African big game thing. This rifle just speaks for itself. There's not much that I can say that you just can't see for yourself. All you need to do is just take a look at the quality and brilliance of the engraving and the gold inlaid. It is believed that only 4 700 Nitro rifles were built by the firm, and based on the serial number of 7004, it is likely that this was the last one produced. I mean, if you take a look at the gold inlay on this side, you got a nice looking Cape Buffalo. And then on the opposite side here, you got that Rhino on the opposite side. So just the case colors pop and they're bright, and gold inlaid with the address on the barrel rib, it just doesn't get much better than that. And this is why it's number 46 on our list. Here we are at number 45 with a heavily documented early production Colt 1878 double action revolver engraved by Gustav Jung and shipped to J.P. Lauer of Denver. This gun was manufactured in 1979 and features the Gustav Jung style of punch dot background with the scroll design, as you can see here. The engraving is seamless across the entire piece. The factory letter states that this revolver was one of two shipped to Lauer and confirms the 4-inch barrel, 45 caliber, nickel finish, and the factory engraving. On an interesting side note, John Lauer of Denver is credited as the first distributor to the 1878 in the ejectorless 4-inch barrel configuration, and actually placed the order 2 months before this revolver ship, making it one of the first of its kind. This gun is documented in multiple books as well, which makes this gun deserving of number 45 on our list. Number 44 is a pair of early Colt automatic pistols, and boy, do we have quite a bit of that high polished Colt blue finish. On my right first is an early production serial number 61 Colt military model 1905 with the box, and is listed in Goddard's book. This is one of only just over 6,200 pistols manufactured over 6 years. These are an important evolutionary step in the development of Colt automatic pistols and the 1911, as they were the first production Colt automatic chambered in 45 ACP. This pistol is so early, it was manufactured even before Colt began fabricating two model examples, which would later be submitted to the 1907 U.S. trials. Moving on to my left here, the next pistol, which is an early production Colt 1902 sporting pistol with the rare picture box. This pistol features the early Colt high polished commercial blue finish and was shipped to LB Croc and Company in New York, who were the original Sears and Roebuck. I mean, it features, it's got to be 99% of the original factory high polish finish, with the hammer right there retaining most of the case colors. They're just popping, they're bright as can be. And then look at the niter blue on the trigger there. This pistol is accompanied by the early Colt maroon cardboard picture box, which has a serial number listed on the underside. These early Colt automatics are just the start of some of the great Colts on our top 50 list, and here they are at number 44. Number 43 is an exceptional grouping of Smith & Wesson new model number 3s belonging to three-time Olympic medalist Walter Winans from none other than, can you guess it? That's right, Dr. Gerald Klaas collection. On my left here is a gold-plated new model number 3, in which you can see here, just going to touch on it quick, you can see the 45 on the side plate there, which was common for Winans to scratch the caliber in on the side of the side plate there. And then moving on to this new model number 3 right here, this blued one, it was shipped to Winans featuring these elaborate ivory grips, gold inlaid with Japanese scenes. In Winans' book, he states in his own words, "I also have a very artistic pair of revolver stock plates, which I had made of ivory and sent to Japan to be inlaid with gold and colored stones. I left the design to the native artist." So saying that, the artist is still unknown and remains unknown, but performed an outstanding and just beautiful job. These grips are out of this world. You see the inlays in the ivory there with the gold and the stones, some pearl, just absolutely unreal. Moving on is this Paris ship new model 3, which was given to Winans by his friend and one of his first opponents in bloodless dueling. That's right. Winans took up bloodless dueling, which utilized wax bullets as sort of a pastime, I guess you could say. It was hardly bloodless though, as Winans shot out the flesh between his friend's thumb and index finger, and Winans did not escape unscathed as he received a flesh wound to an arm. So, and then our last but not least group from our group of Winans new models 3 is a cased pair of Gustav Jung engraved new model 3s, which were owned by two of the most renowned target shooters, Walter Winans and Ira Payne. This pair was originally shipped to Ira Payne. After Payne's death, this pair and other target handguns were purchased by Winans. The case features Walter Winans' personal paper label on the interior of the lid, and his initials are branded on the top of the lid as well with a WW. At 43, these are the first, but definitely not the last Smith & Wessons you'll see from Dr. Klaas's collection on our top 50 for this auction. Number 42 is the first lever action on our list, and it is this fresh and phenomenal panel seam engraved Marlin 1893 takedown rifle. Not only that, but it features an added elegance of gold and platinum inlaid borders. The real centerpiece of this rifle, though, is the engraved panel game scene, which you can see right here, which depicts a hunter firing his trusty Marlin at a running stag. You can see some smoke engraved in there coming out from behind the tree. This is a true work of Marlin artistry, and that's why it is number 42 on our list. Number 41, and my last installment on our top 50, is this outstanding Winchester Deluxe 1873. And I think all I have to say is holy case colors. If you're a Winchester collector, you'll understand why it is on the list. This gun features multiple special order features, which are confirmed by the accompanying letter. Checkered pistol grip stock, half octagon barrel, half magazine tube, vernier and beech sights, and the case hardened finish. This gun retains bright original case colors that, along with the documented special order features, are why it is number 41 on our list. I'm Alex Janoski, Director of Client Services here at Rock Island Auction Company, and it has been my pleasure to share number 50 through 41 on the top 50 of our May 2021 premier auction with you.